Now, welcome to Naples in southern Italy for day three of shooting action from the 2019 Summer Universiade. Shooting taking place at the Mostra d'Oltremare venues just to the west of Naples. And today, fans looking ahead to the men's 10-meter rifle competition. So let's get down to the serious business. Now, in qualifying, Evgeny Panchenko was absolutely brilliant. 6:30 is a real mark that these shooters aim for, and he was the only one who got past it. And as you can see, by quite a distance, by nearly 5 points. And the best eight have made it to the final. We'll run through the finalists in a few seconds. They'll shoot up to 24 times. Remember, the first two series of five each, and then after that, series of two, after which the lower scorer is eliminated. So, Panchenko, Fetisov for Russia, Yanni from Slovakia, Nekunam, Iran, Rossita, Australia, Kang, China, Park from South Korea, and Bacci from Italy. You may notice the interesting uniforms that these shooters have. Obviously, everything is completely legal, but they're individually made. The idea is to stiffen the stance and to stop swaying of the body. And one rule that's quite interesting, if you look at the ISSF rule book, as I have, is that you must be able to walk in these suits, which sounds obvious, but they mustn't be too stiff to give you an undue advantage. So if you want to know the definition of walking, look on the ISSF site and you'll have it. It basically means that the heel hitting the floor before the toe. If that can't be the case, if shooters can't walk in that way, they can't compete. But all these eight have passed that test. So the individual eyewear that you may see, which is not so much about increasing and focusing the target, it's about getting a depth of vision. For those of you who like photography, it's about getting a bigger range of a vision and allowing the target and the gun to be in focus at the same time, increasing the depth of field. And another piece of equipment to the blinders, just to cut out any interference from the weaker eye. So let's look at some of the early scores. And from Iran, Nekunam and Panchenko with a couple of 10.5s early on, very early days. Yanni has just hit a perfect 10.9. Some applause you can hear there, brilliantly done from the Slovak. But Fetisov still leads. So we've had the first series of five shots, and Fetisov leads the way with 52.1.
He shot an excellent score of 52.1. All five of his shots landed in the 10th ring. Just behind Fetisov.
So this is how it stands after five shots. Fetisov with that lead, 0.3 of a point ahead of Yanni. South Korea's Park Hae-jun, 51.7, and Yanni profiting from a super 10.9 just a few seconds ago.
10.7 in his fourth and fifth shot. He's currently in fifth position. This will be the second series of five shots.
We're getting ready for the second series of five shots here in Napoli for the 10-meter air rifle competition. And for the moment, it's perhaps the narrow favorite after qualifying down in fourth, Panchenko, and the other Russian, Fetisov, who's leading with 52.1 points. But it's very close and a long, long way to go. Big 10.7 for Kang Zengu. He'll be delighted with that, and that's better from Rossiter as well. But Nekunam has also hit a 10.6. So that's interesting. The two at the bottom of your screen, seventh and eighth, have shot really well. 10.2 from Nekunam. Shooters do have very different rhythms. As long as they hit their five shots in the 250 seconds, they can shoot quickly, shoot slowly. That's up to them. Good 10.7 from Yanni. A disappointing 9.9 from Fetisov. Maybe the pressure showing. So much of this sport is mental, of course. 10.7, that's better from Fetisov. So we've come to the end indeed of the second round of 10 shots, and Fetisov still leads 105.1, and he's 0.3 ahead of Yanni.
Both scored 53 points with that series. Wow.
So that's the situation after 10 shots. Both hit 53 dead in that second set of five shots. So really consistent shooting for them. They look like the favorites at the moment. Park Hajun still in the hunt, but they're all in it for the moment. Now is the time, though, that we're gonna get some eliminations. And Patrick Yanni will know he's in with a chance. And Park Hajun, if he does something spectacular, could have another South Korean gold medal. So we've already had one on the second day of action with Park Dae-hoon. So here we go, shots 11 and 12. Oh dear, Fetisov has only hit 9.1. That's disappointing for him. But not for Yanni. Yanni goes ahead. Yanni takes the lead by the narrowest of margins. So now we're gonna see who will be the first to be eliminated. So it's between Rossiter and Nekunam. So Rossiter has some work to do to stay in the competition. The Australian, the 2016 Olympian. He needs to make up 0.5 points. So Rossiter's hit a 9.6. I don't think that'll be good enough. And a 10.4. And Nekunam is it a 10 dead. So Jack Rossiter couldn't quite stay in contention there, but he's made a final, and he can be proud of himself there. Eighth place for Jack Rossiter from Adelaide in Australia.
Yanni Osunakia shot a 10.4. There were some other really good shots. Bacci in the Italian 10.7. He stays in six. And Bunchenko of Russia, he moves up to third position.
So we have our first elimination, Jack Rossiter.
This is the 13th shot in the
corner. We are down to seven. Now on to shots 13 and 14. Fetisov leads by a mere 0.1 point. It's a really close scrap between those two. With Panchenko in third now. 10.6 for Panchenko. It's a 10.8 for Fetisov. Brilliantly done. And a 10.8 for Bacci as well. That was the reason for those applause and the cheers. That'll do Lorenzo Bacci's cause a great deal of good. So Fetisov is 0.7 ahead of Yanni. So, Bacci or Nekunam? Surely Bacci will stay in contention because there's a big gap between the two, but one never knows in shooting. Lorenzo Bacci against Amir Nekunam of Iran, the 20-year-old, against the 24-year-old, excuse me, from Italy. But Fetisov leads the way. Shots 15 and 16, 10.4 for Yanni, 10.3 for Panchenko. There's a huge 10.7 for Nekunam, but Bacci doing even better with a 10.8. There's no way he's going to go down for the moment. He wants to stay in contention as long as he possibly can. So it's Amir Nekunam who finishes seventh. So we've had two eliminations. Nekunam seventh and Rossiter eighth, down to the business end.
He shot a 10.8 for the second time in a row, and that's finally enough for him to move up.
Really good work from Bacci there. And who knows, maybe he's in with a medal contention, 144. The bronze medalist at the moment is Panchenko with 145.1. So there's time to make that up, you know. If Bacci shoots really well, there could be an Italian medal. this afternoon.
For the next competition shot, low.
We're getting ready for shots 15 and 16 in this men's 10-meter air rifle competition. Russia leading the way. It's a 10.7 from Yanni and a good 10.6 from Bacci. He's shooting very, very consistently, you know. Still in the hunt. Only a 10.1 for Park.
Stop.
And Fetisov has only hit a 9.8. That's sensational. Yanni hits the head of this competition. What a scrap between Yanni and Fetisov. And after 15 shots, it's Yanni who's ahead. So shot 16 is between Bacci and Kang, and surely that's too big of a gap for Kang. Looks like the last threat from China is going to disappear. We're going to be down to the last five, but one never knows. So shot number 16, we're ready to go. Bacci against Kang to see who goes out, but it would need a very poor shot from Bacci for him to be eliminated. Panchenko's a 10.3, incidentally. Let's see what Bacci has up his sleeve. 10.5, good work from him. And he stays in contention, and that'll be the end of Kang Zhenggu. Another good 10.5 for Fetisov. Panchenko looking at Yanni, only 10 dead. Kang hits a 9.9. So that's the end of the road for Kang Zhenggu, but he can be proud of his performance to reach six. This is the biggest competition of his international career. So well done to him. Kang Zhenggu in sixth. You're watching pictures from the men's 10-meter air rifle competition, the final in Naples. We're down to the last five, with Fetisov leading the way by 0.4 points after 16 shots. And Patrick Yanni of second, those two having a fabulous scrap. And the gap between those five is only 1.3 points. So they'll all certainly think they're in with a chance of a medal, but only a 9.8 for Bacci. It's a shame for him and a disappointment for Italy. 10.1 for Yanni, and a huge 10.8 for Park. South Korea will be delighted with that. Easily the best shot, 10.8. The next best was a 10.1 from Yanni and Fetisov. So good work from Park Hae-jun. So it's between Bacci and Panchenko. Now Bacci has to do some work now because there's 0.4 points to make up. Panchenko, I don't know if he hits a good shot, 10.4, 10.5, that should be enough. Tension is on. And will an Italian finish fifth again? It was the Italian fifth in the pistol. We might have the same thing in the rifle. Let's have a look. 40 seconds left in this round of shooting. Bacci needs to be, I think, perfect or close to perfect, and just hope for the best. Hope that Panchenko may be affected by nerves. Well, Fetisov's been hit by nerves, I think, only 9.6. A chance for Yanni to hit the top, 9.8. Now, and a 10.6 for Bacci, but it's not quite enough, I don't think. No. Oh, that's so close, that's so hard on Lorenzo Bacci. 10.6. But not quite enough there for Bacci. But he'll get a huge round of applause. Lorenzo Bacci in fifth. He was third in qualifying at 627.3. And he will end up in fifth place. Now, we're down to the last four. Three of these four will go home. with a medal. But the big news now is Park Hae-jun, for the first time, is leading after 18 shots. He's in pole position after Fetisov, and Yanni shot quite poorly in the last two shots. We have four competitors left in this 10-meter air rifle competition. And we've just seen, for the first time, Park Hae-jun of South Korea hit the front after Fetisov and Yanni of Russia and Slovakia shoot quite poorly, not making 10 points. And there's another threat from Russia with the Evgeny Panchenko, who was best in qualifying. 10.8 for Panchenko. Brilliantly done from him. About four good shots there. 10.6 for Park. It's just getting closer and closer. And Yanni and Panchenko are actually tied. Could not be any closer for the bronze medal. They always say fourth is the worst position to finish in a major international competition like this. Who will finish fourth, I wonder? Yanni or Panchenko? Park still leads. 0.5 the lead for the South Korean. But who will be eliminated, Yanni or Panchenko? It's a straight shootout between Yanni and Panchenko. Panchenko is at a 10.6. Who will have the medal? And it will be Panchenko, because Yanni is at a 10.4. Oh, that's so disappointing for him. And a touch unlucky. He's come so close. But fourth place for Patrick. Fetisov, in fact, is fourth, because Yanni has done enough, excuse me, to go ahead of Fetisov. So Fetisov has just gone down from first to second to fourth. So Yanni will at least have a bronze, and maybe better. With three left in contention, it's Park, Panchenko and Yanni. We're now going to decide which colour medals will be distributed, with Park, Panchenko and Yanni in contention. Fetisov has just been eliminated, and Yanni just clinging on by the skin of his teeth. It's now very close between those front three. Real drama and tension in this arena in Naples. Only a 9.3 for Panchenko, but a big 10.6 for Yanni. Coming good when he really needs it. Panchenko is in third. That's quite a big difference now, you know. 1.1 between Yanni and Panchenko. Panchenko needs to do something very special here. 1.1 points. The difference. So Panchenko currently in third. We'll be hoping beyond hope that he can shoot really well and get in the top two and stay in the hunt for gold. Yanni's a 10.9, it's perfect from Yanni. Panchenko's good as well, a 10.8 and a 10.8 for Park. Well, all of these three shooters coming good when they really need it, in money time, as they say. But the bronze will go to Evgeny Panchenko. It's not often you say this, but 10.8, not enough. Panchenko with the bronze, and he can be very proud of that performance as well, breaking a Universiade record in qualies. But it's between Park and Yanni for the gold. We're down to the last two shots in this air rifle competition. And Parker's led after the last three rounds of shooting. But the gap is only 0.3 points, and Yanni has pulled out some huge numbers when he absolutely needed it. And there's some Slovak fans, you can see, support for their man. He has to take 0.3 points over these last two shots. Certainly capable of doing it, but obviously Park Hae-jun is in the better position. Let's see who will go home with the gold. Is it Park of South Korea or Yanni of Slovakia? .10.7 for Yanni, nicely done. And .10.3 for Park. Well, Yanni is going to take the lead. That's sensational. Yanni has not been ahead since the 12th shot, but he's kept in, he's hanging on in there. But it couldn't be any closer. 0.1 points the gap. Well, this is a sensational finish to the air pistol, the air rifle final, after the air pistol was significantly less close. So the final shot, it's Yanni against Park. 0.1 points the difference. And we're going to find out who's going to go home with gold in the next 50 seconds. Huge tension here. Significant Slovak support, and I think the Korean knows it. Has to calm himself. All those hours and hours of practice and preparation. They're all for a moment like this, a gold medal up for grabs. And the difference, a mere 0.1 points. 10.1 for Yanni. Well, that might not be good enough, you know. Well, Park's only hit time, 9.3. Park Hae-jun with a disappointing shot at the end. I wasn't sure if 10.1 would be enough, but it was, you know. And Patrick Yanni is going to go home with a sensational gold medal in the air rifle competition. A 10.1 ended up good enough because Park Hae-jun could only hit a 9.3 when it really mattered. And it ended up as a 0.9 point difference, which is quite significant, but it was very, very close going into the end. And that's hard on Park, because Park led all the way after the rounds 18, 20 and 22 shots. But it was Yanni who was ahead after the 12th shot, who just hung on and just kept consistent and used all those hours of preparation to go home with the gold and to shoot, to get just what he needed. And that's brilliantly done from him. And the Slovak team will be celebrating tonight with a very good performance from Patrick Yanni. He goes home with gold. Park, second. And a bronze medal for Evgeny Panchenko.